for you. Yeah, and I want you to Jesus somehow, take your seat, y'all, I'm trying to hurry up. He somehow finds something praiseworthy about us. Think about that in light of your own worth, in light of your own value, in light of your own esteem. There should be nobody sitting in this church suffering from low self-esteem and low value. Shake yourself and get that revelation in your spirit that Jesus is praising God for you. That may not mean a lot to y'all. I got more to preach, but I just feel a praise right there. Because when I think about how much I messed up, when I think about how I failed him over and over and over, when I think about how I should have been cut off a long time ago, and don't you sit there looking at me crazy. You should have been cut off a long time ago too. When you are considerate of that, and when you get real with yourself, you ought to be praising the Lord that he's praising God for you. And not just when he has honored our prayer request, but we praise him continually. And not just when he grants us a measure of his divine favor, but we praise him continually. Not just when he blesses us with an open door or a wonderful opportunity, but we praise him continually. Not just for some material blessing is manifest in our lives, but we praise him continually. Paul said to the saints in Thessalonica, in everything give thanks. In everything give thanks. In everything, give thanks. Not just when you got a filet mignon, but if you got hash browns. Ah, God, continually. Not just when you at Ruth Chris, but when you in the drive-thru in McDonald's, in the 99-cent menu. Give thanks continually. Not just when you get a Mercedes, but while you're on the bus, with one bus pass left, give thanks continually. I want you to understand that there is a growing segment of the body of Christ that declares that verbal shouts of praise and adoration is outdated. I'm about to put my foot on the devil. Yeah, it's outdated. Yeah, it's old school preaching. Yeah, some folk even consider it to be ignorant. It's an ignorant depiction of color folk back in the 60s and the 50s. We have matured now. We're more educated. We're more sophisticated. We've learned the difference between a salad fork and a main entree fork. We've learned the difference on how to place our napkin properly on our lap. We've learned how to take our elbows off the table. Many of us have learned how to extend our pinky when we take a sip of our drink. Y'all ain't saying nothing to me. We have grown and matured. We have bachelor's degrees, and we have education. We got doctor's degrees, and we are in high places. We're doctors and lawyers, and when we have highfalutin jobs, and we work at Fortune 500 companies. We are multimillionaires. We have arrived, and it don't take all of that. When we were enslaved and during the civil rights movement, I understand it. But ever since us being set free, it don't take all of that. That's barbaric. You ain't gotta do all that in church. See, that's why I don't fool with Temple of Refuge. Cause every time I come there, they just be shouting and praising God all the time. It don't take all of that. But I want you to know it takes all of that plus some more.